It is my proud privilege to be joined on this special broadcast from Ground Zero by heroes of that Kargil War of 1999. Those who served in this battle, who led from the front. And let me begin by introducing all our guests. Let me begin by, from one side, Colonel Amit Ohl, Sena Medal, a young captain during the Kargil War, was at the line of control. I'd interviewed these young officers that time, now senior officers. Major General Ravindra Singh of the 8th Sikh Battalion was a part of the Tiger Hill operations. Again, my proud privilege, then Brigadier Amar Ohl, retired as Lieutenant General Amar Ohl, was commanding the Drass Brigade, had interacted extensively with the Brigadier Ohl on my other side. So we've done the Drass Mashko sector on one side. I come to the Batalik sector on the other side. Brigadier Devinder Singh commanded the 70 Infantry Brigade, a para gunner. Proud privilege, had interacted with him also during Kargil War, was commanding the Batalik Brigade. Then Major Sonam Wangchuk, Mahavir Chakra, Ladakh Scouts, Colonel Sonam Wangchuk, and Brigadier B.M. Karyappa, if I may, I mean, when you look at that chest, which is so full of rows and rows of ribbons and medals, Veer Chakra, Sena Medal, Wound Medal, Special Forces, and the medals just go on, Operation Vijay, Operation Meghdoot. Now, when you see these big row of medals on all sides, you know how brave these officers were and are in this operation. And let me begin by asking Brigadier Karyappa how he feels today, the operations that he had undertaken during Op Vijay. Sir, such a proud privilege to have you on this special broadcast. Sir, your thoughts today on your operations then?
The operations which I led were primarily the first feature that was captured in Batalik, that was 0.5203, where two assaults had gone in previously. First assault was led by Subedar Anchuk Dorji of Ladakh Scouts. We lost about 14 troops, including Subedar Anchuk Dorji. And the second assault was by 12 Jakalai, where we lost Amul Kalia. Yes. And they managed to get a lodgement on 5203. The third assault, which was led by me, there was one team of five para and there were two teams of Ladakh Scouts. We had success by the next day. We had the tricolor flying on 0.5203. The second assault was on the line of control, where we assaulted these two features. My unit assaulted Konikal and Ringkantur. I led the assault on Konikal, and Major Jaggi, he led the assault on Ringkantur. That was quite a bloody battle. I mean, there were quite a few casualties on the Pakistani side. Unfortunately, it's not much in the news because there was not much coverage because it was a difficult area to access.
Guilty as charged, but to be fair, I tried. I really tried to get to Batalik as often as I could. But, you know, let me also come to then Major Sonam Wangchuk, now Colonel Sonam Wangchuk. Sir, your operation, the Veer Chakra that you won, was a very, very difficult operation for Ladakh Scouts.
Firstly, Mahavir, I would like Chakra. To, yeah, Mahavir Chakra. So I was with Ladakh Scouts at that point in time. And within a short span of time, from starting from 26th till 31st, I would say around 6 days, it shows the resilience and the adaptability of the Indian Army soldiers. So I didn't get much of a time. We were mobilized on 26th, and thereafter we were launched into the battlefield on 28th, when through Hanuthang Axis, we went to Hindenburg, from where the operations they were conducted. So it was basically, you know, based on information wherein I was given information of enemy being in a large strength there, and general area was Chorbatla. Yes. So I was leading Foxtrot Company, Indus Wing, Ladakh Scouts that time, and we had just about, I think, 40 boys, because the majority of the boys, they had been siphoned out. 40 boys, I think, at least, and they were given other tasks. So it was a preemptive operation launched to occupy the eastern flank of Chorbatla, wherein I lost a boy, and thereafter we were able to capture a post of the enemy. When we got ambushed, and thereafter in a counter ambush, we could kill about 11 enemy soldiers. And yeah.
Brilliant operation. And, you know, it was so good meeting him during Op Vijay, and subsequently, two brigade commanders with me, the Batalik brigade commander, guilty as charged. We did not get much access to you, sir, but very difficult operations you undertook there.
So, like I said, Batalik was the first intrusion, and the moment it was entrusted to us, we had no troops, but the troops started coming in bits and pieces, and the two actions you have already heard, 5203 with Karyapa, and some other Ladakh troops, and Sonam Wangchu did the Chor Batla before that, and Chor Batla was the extremity of 70 Brigade, whereas Jupar was the left extreme, and in the center was the Khaluwar, etc., which we attempted as a simultaneous attack with 7 battalions finally, and we were on top by 5th July, and by 9th July we were on the line of control where Karyapa just told you he brought in fire on himself because he was being attacked by the 33rd Frontier Force which had come in from Rawalpindi. And that really gave casualties of over 40 to 50 to the enemy. And these casualties were Punjabi Muslims. And that really pinched the Pakistan army because they were from the capital. Otherwise, they were not bothered about the non-light infantry. And this is the thing which, in my view, asked them for a ceasefire around the 12th of July.
Amazing. An officer who calls on fire on himself so that the enemy can be put down. That was the valor of the Indian Army. Let me now shift focus to operations in the Dras and the Mashko Valley sector. Then Brigadier Amar Aul, sir, it was a privilege to see you in operations at that point of time. But what was the most difficult operation for you? You know, this was a war that we were seeing on the roadhead here. You were seeing it all the way till the LC.
Yeah, I came with my brigade with two battalions from the valley to Dras on 13th of May. And one battalion was taken away from me for some subsequent operations. So I had just one battalion left with about 5 fire units. And my boys were not acclimatized. It took me about 6 to 7 days to acclimatize them. And thereafter, I was told to capture Tololing at the earliest. With just one battalion and no ATs, no animal transport, no porters, we took this task on, and we were able to clear the ridgelines leading to the Tololing top by the end of May. And this was a great thing by 18 Grenadiers. We lost a couple of officers like Ravindranath, the 2IC, Adhikari. It was very difficult times. We did not have fire support. We did not have enough troops. We did not have animal transport, and we were throughout shelling the 60 days that I was here.
Absolutely. And I remember I had once seen you. I wonder if you remember, sir, one Bofors you had, you were sitting right here, and that was in direct firing mode here. That time I was too scared to ask you, what was that operation?
Oh, that was operations by the 18 Garhwal. They were stuck with one of the bunkers which was holding out, and the only way to do it was to get the Bofors in the direct firing role and get that particular bunker, which we did.
And the brigade commander himself was sitting on the road, on the pavement, and directing that fire. Privileged to have seen that, sir. Another unique aspect. So the father was the brigade commander. The son was at the line of control. Amit, can I request you to come closer? So Colonel Amit Aul, then a young captain, won Sena Medal for gallantry during that operations. How difficult were your operations?
The operations, I think we were young. The operations were difficult. I think operations, in which any operation and every operation led, were very, very difficult operations. The ridges are in front of you. They were 80 degree, 90 degree slopes. We used ropes. We crawled up. So they were very, very difficult operations.
Let me also quickly cut across to then a young major, now Major General Ravindra Singh of the 8th Battalion of the 6th Regiment. Sir, you were tasked at that point of time to lead or to be a part of a very difficult operation on Tiger Hill. And this was a multi-pronged offensive.
Yes, it was a multi-pronged offensive. We were launched along with 18 Grenadiers. The operations of the battalion had got a little stalled. So that's why they had to launch us. And I had gone with the Ghatak platoon onto India Gate and Helmet, which are the parts of Tiger Hill. And the capture of India Gate and Helmet was very important tactically and strategically, both ways, because to capture Tiger Hill, India Gate and Helmet had to be cleared. And to dominate National Highway, Tiger Hill had to be cleared. So it was actually like a suicidal mission in which we had gone about 52 soldiers. And I must say, I bow my head to the martyrs who had laid down their life. There were 3 JCOs and 15 OR who laid down that life on that particular day. They laid down their lives. And similarly, 21 soldiers were injured. But then, you know, the spirit of Indian Army, the spirit of Sikh regiment, Nishchay kar apni jeet karo, we could achieve what, to my mind, initially was looking very difficult, though people are calling it, it is like something which is very impossible.
It was seen as mission impossible at that point of time, Tiger Hill operations, but Nishchay kar apni jeet karo, a very, very significant line, you know, De Shiva bar mohe ehe, shubh karman se kapahu na taru, na daru ari soh jab jai larau, Nishchay kar apni jeet karo. So was this that mindset? And then for a father, after so many years, I can ask you that question. For a father, is it difficult that you are commanding a brigade where you're launching troops into operation in harm's way and your son is one of those soldiers?
Well, yes, he did ring me up on the radio saying that I'm going out for operations. I only said that, look, all the best. I'm sure you will succeed. You see, we were, as a father and son, you may say that, yes, we have feelings towards each other. But as a brigade commander, as far as sons are concerned, all my soldiers are my sons. And he was one of the soldiers that took this operation on him. And I'm very proud that he was not in my brigade, but in an adjacent brigade and did extremely well.
You know, and as a reporter who was covering the war in 1999, I had reported this story of the father commanding the brigade and the son as part of Gurkha Paltan being at the line of control. And then I had learnt of several such instances of father and son, brother and brother, who were in the same operation. And in one case, there was an instance that one soldier was killed in action. The other soldier was still in harm's way. Did the army then think of withdrawing, you know, some of these soldiers when both siblings were in harm's way so that at least the family would have one person alive?
No, not really. It was totally, when you get into such operations, your focus is on the task that has been given to you. You do not look behind on your family or who is your kith and kin. Your focus is to achieve whatever target has been given to you.
That you were very clear that you are not fighting Mujahideen. You were very clear you were fighting the Pakistan Army?
Absolutely. The unit we were fighting was 19 Frontier Force. Once the attacks were launched, once we started taking their posts, we found documents, we found weapons, and finally, by the end of our operations, we recovered a soldier alive from 19 Frontier Force.
So that was proof of Pakistan's involvement in treachery. Soldiers, Pakistani soldiers were caught alive in the Batalik sector. Pakistani soldiers were caught alive here in the Dras and Mashko Valley sector.